Hello everyone. Last class we studied about organic light emitting diode. In this session I am here with a new topic. Before enter into the topic, I will show you some images. Here I am not going to ask the topic name. Instead of that, you are going to find out the output name. Output means it's not a number but something produced by a device. It may be a light or it may be a sound or it may be a force. You have to find out. This output is used in these devices in some other way. So I can read your mind. You are saying there is no similarities between this picture, but she is saying to find out the answer. No problem. I will give the clue from that you can find out. So here we have the clue. It's a light source. So you go through all the images. What you are seeing in both the images, you are seeing red color light. And also, this light source look like a narrow beam. Can you guess the name? Most of you may guess the name. Shall we check it out with the next picture? Now all are clear about the answer. That is a laser. We are played with this pointer in childhood days. This pointer producing laser light. So in this class we are going to learn how to produce laser light. Laser, it is abbreviated as light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Lasers are produced by four ways. In solid state laser, the solid is used as the laser medium. Neodymium doped deuterium aluminium garnet is the example for solid state laser. In gas laser, the laser medium is in the gaseous state. Helium neon laser and argon ion laser, carbon dioxide lasers are the example for gas laser. In liquid laser, liquid is used as the laser medium. Dye laser is the example for liquid laser. In semiconductor laser, p-n junction diode is used as the active medium. So nowadays semiconductor laser playing a many important role in our everyday life. So these lasers are very cheap, compact size and consume low power. It is also known as laser diode. So in this class, we are going to produce a laser by this semiconductor laser method. It is also called laser diode. These are the content of my topic. Let us see the basics of a laser diode. So this is the full form of laser, light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Here, light is amplified by stimulated emission process. What is amplification? In Tamil, we can say pericum. So in mic also we are using amplification factor. So here this term is used to indicate the in order to increase the light intensity. So stimulator mean thoonduthal. So light intensity is amplified by stimulated process. So here a semiconductor laser diode are used to produce a laser. In this case, we are going to apply a potential difference across a modified p-n junction diode. So p-n junction la nama or potential difference apply panni nama laser ah produce panna porom. So this semiconductor laser is also called injection laser diode or diode laser. Here the working principle or working or operation is similar to light emitting diode, but light emitting diode emits incoherent light and here, laser diode emits a coherent light, that is a laser. Do you know about coherent? So we will see here. So this is the difference between coherent laser light and incoherent LED. You can find the difference. So here, starting point from starting to finishing is same. So that is called in phase with each other. And wavelength also same. Here, wavelength and phase is not same. In addition to, it is a monochromatic light. Monochromatic means it has the same color. If the color of the beam is red, means the whole beam has the same red color. So this is the difference between coherent and incoherent. Coherent ko incoherent ko enna difference na. So idoda starting point eppadi aarambikkidho adhe maari da finishing varaikku irukum. அதோட வேவ்லென்த் சேமா இருக்கும், அதோட ஃப்ரீக்வன்சி சேமா இருக்கும். ஒருவேளை ரெட் கலர்ல இருந்துச்சுன்னா அது எல்லாமே ரெட் கலர்ல இருக்கும், கிரீன் கலர்ல இருக்கும்னா எல்லா லைட்டுமே க்ரீன் கலர்ல இருக்கும். ஸோ இன்கோகரண்ட்ல எப்படி இருக்கும்னா அதோட ஃபேஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்டாக இருக்கும், ஒவ்வொன்றும் ஒவ்வொரு டைரக்ஷன்ல இருக்கும். இதுதான் கோகரண்ட் அண்ட் இன்கோகரண்ட். தெர் ஆர் டூ டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் செமிகண்டக்டர் லேசர் டயோட். ஒன் இஸ் ஹோமோ ஜங்ஷன் செமிகண்டக்டர் டயோட், அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் ஹெட்ரோ ஜங்ஷன் செமிகண்டக்டர் டயோட். ஹோமோ மீன்ஸ் சேம். ஸோ ஹியர் சேம் மெட்டீரியல் இஸ் யூஸ் டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் பிஎன் ஜங்ஷன். பிஎன் ஜங்ஷனில் சேம் மெட்டீரியலை யூஸ் பண்ணி நம்ம வந்து லேசர் லைட்டை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணோம்னா அதை ஹோமோ ஜங்ஷன் செமிகண்டக்டர் டயோட்னு சொல்லுவோம். ஹெட்ரோ மீன்ஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட். ஸோ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் இஸ் யூஸ் டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் பிஎன் ஜங்ஷன். ஸோ பிஎன் ஜங்ஷனை நம்ம டிஃப்ரெண்ட் மெட்டீரியலை யூஸ் பண்ணி லேசர் லைட்டை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணோம்னா தட் இஸ் கால்டு ஹெட்ரோ ஜங்ஷன் செமிகண்டக்டர் டயோட். ஸோ ஹியர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் லேசர் பை ஹெட்ரோ ஜங்ஷன் செமிகண்டக்டர் டயோட். Now let us see some characteristics which we get from heterojunction semiconductor diode. So these are the characteristics. Here active medium is p-n junction with a different layer. Here active center is recombination of electrons and holes. Pumping process, it's a direct pumping. Optical resonator, polished junction of diode. So we can get power output 10 milliwatt. Nature of output is a continuous waveform. So wavelength we can get from here 8000 Armstrong and band here 1.55 electron volt. Now let us see the principle of laser diode. When we forward bias, the electrons in the conduction band combines with the holes in the valence band, and hence the recombination, the photon produced in the form of light. This photon again induce the electrons in the conduction band and holes in the valence band, and that way it will stimulate the emission of another photon. So in the system of forward bias la nama connect panumbodhu conduction band la irukkira electrons valence band la irukkira holes oda combined agum. In the recombination process nala inga photons produce agum in the form of light. இந்த ஃபோட்டான் என்ன பண்ணும்னா ரிமைனிங் இருக்கிற எலக்ட்ரான்ஸையும் ஹோல்ஸையும் கம்பைன் பண்ணி இந்த நியூ ஃபோட்டான்ஸை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணும். இந்த ப்ராசஸ் தான் திரும்ப திரும்ப நடந்து நமக்கு லேசர் அவுட்புட் கிடைக்கும். திஸ் இஸ் த பிரின்சிபல் ஆஃப் லேசர் டயோட். நெக்ஸ்ட் வி வில் சி த கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் ஆஃப் லேசர் டயோட். லெட் அஸ் சி த கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் ஆஃப் லேசர் டயோட். இட் ஹேவ் ஃபைவ் லேயர்ஸ், 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. த தேர்ட் லேயர் இட் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆக்டிவ் ரீஜியன். It has a narrow band gap. So this third layer is sandwiched between second and fourth layer. Second layer is made up of P material and fourth layer is made up of N material. Second and fourth layer have a more wider band gap than three. First layer, it is called a contact layer. And this fourth layer is grown over here. Fifth layer, that is called substrate layer. For upper electrode and lower electrode, it is connected to the battery in order to produce the forward bias. This third and fourth layer is covered by optical resonator. Optical resonator means it has two mirror. One is reflective mirror, another one is partially reflective mirror. So in partially reflecting mirror, it has a small opening. From that, the producing laser will emit. This is the structure of laser diode. Now let us see the working of laser diode. First, the diode is forward biased. Usually, forward biased means the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the P region and negative terminal of the battery is connected to the N region. But here we have electrodes, so the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the upper electrode and negative terminal of the battery is connected to the lower electrodes. Due to this forward bias, the charge carriers are produced in P region and N region, that is second and fourth layers. So if we increase the potential, the charge carriers from second region or second layer is moved to active layer, and charge carriers from fourth layer is moved to active region. So like this. So as the charge carriers are continuously injected from second and fourth layer to third layer until the population inversion is achieved. Population inversion means we can have more electrons in the conduction band and holes in the valence band. At this state, the electrons fall into the holes and it produces photons in the form of light. These photons induce the charge carriers to emit photons in phase. As a result, more number of photons are produced. As a result, more number of stimulated emission arises and a large number of photons are produced. These photons are reflected back and forth at the junction and a laser beams emerges out from the PN active region, or we can say in between the third and fourth layer. This is the working of laser diode. I will repeat it once again. The positive terminal of the battery is connected to the upper electrode and negative terminal of the battery is connected to the lower electrode. So, enna ahum forward bias la connect pannumbodhu charge carriers produce ahum P region liyo, N region liyo. Adutthu namma further a namma vandhu apply pandra electric field ayo increase pannumbodhu இந்த செகண்ட் லேயர்ல இருக்கிற சார்ஜ் கேரியர்ஸும் ஃபோர்த் லேயர்ல இருக்கிற சார்ஜ் கேரியர்ஸும் இங்க ஆக்டிவ் ரீஜியனுக்கு மூவ் ஆகும். ஸோ கண்டக்ஷன் பேண்ட்ல எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் அண்ட் வேலன்ஸ் பேண்ட்ல ஹோல்ஸ் இருக்கு. ஹியர் வி ஹாவ் மோர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் இன் த கண்டக்ஷன் பேண்ட் அண்ட் மோர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஹோல்ஸ் இன் த வேலன்ஸ் பேண்ட். ஸோ பாப்புலேஷன் இன்வர்ஷன் இஸ் அச்சீவ். ஸோ அடுத்து என்ன பண்ணணும்னா இந்த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் இந்த ஹோல்ஸோட கம்பைன்ட் ஆகும். கம்பைன்ட் ஆகி நமக்கு ஒரு ஃபோட்டானை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணும். இந்த ஃபோட்டான் என்ன பண்ணும்னா சார்ஜ் கேரியர்ஸ் ரிமைனிங் இருக்கிற சார்ஜ் கேரியரை ஸ்டிமுலேட் பண்ணி தூண்டி நமக்கு ஒரே ஃபேஸில் இருக்கிற லேசர் லைட்டை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணும். ஸோ இந்த ப்ராசஸ் கண்டினியூஸாக நடந்து ஸோ இந்த மாதிரி பீம்ஸு ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆகும். இந்த மாதிரி ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆகிற பீம்ஸு இங்கே ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆகி இங்கே மூவ் ஆகி நமக்கு ஒரு பீம் லேசர் பீமாக ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆகி இந்த ஏரியாவில் நமக்கு அவுட்புட் நம்ம எடுக்கலாம். So this is the working of laser diode. Let us see the advantages of laser diode. Very high output, high power output is generated in laser. It produces continuous wave output. That means it has constant amplitude. High coherent light is generated by laser. Coherence means it has the same phase and frequency, or one can say same phase and same wavelength. Directionality is high. So we can send laser light at very long distance. It has the low threshold current density compared to homojunction laser. So it need a small amount of current to get a high output. Directionality is high, so we can say use this laser for long distance communication. Compared to light emitting diode, these diodes are highly stable and it has a longer lifetime, approximately 25,000 to 50,000 hours. In days, we can say approximately 1,041 to 2,083 days it may work. These are the advantages of laser diode. Now, let us see the disadvantage of laser diode. It has a high cost when compared to homojunction laser diode. And practical difficulties arises while growing different layers of PN junction diode. Next, let us see the application of laser diode. Laser having so many applications in scientific, medical, commercial and military applications. Let us see one by one. In CDs and DVD players, it is used to read the information stored on it. And in laser printer, it is used to print text or images onto the paper. In fax machine, it is used to produce at least 20 pages per minute and good image quality. In television, laser is used to produce a color video display. And here in laser pointer, it is used in many colleges and school for presentation. In barcode scanner, lasers is used to read the printed barcodes. In medical field, laser used in many ways. For example, it will used to treat a retina. It is used to destroy the tumor and cancer cells. And also it is used to breaking the stone in human kidneys. In lighting show, the use of laser light to entertain audience. In machining, it is focused on the workpiece to be machined. In range finder, it is used to determine the distance of an object. So next, it is used in intrusion detection system. Intrusion means entrance by without information. So it will helpful in army to find the terrorists. If we want to give signal from earth to satellite, we can use laser. These are the application of laser diode. I summarize my topic. This class we studied about laser, and it is produced by semiconductor laser diode. Laser diode has two types. One is homo junction laser diode and a hetero junction laser diode. In homo junction we have same p-n material. In hetero junction we have different p-n material. And p-n junction is used as active medium to produce laser. When we apply voltage, the electron in the conduction band and holes in the valence band recombine in the active region, and it produces photons. This photon stimulate the emission of the another photon. The laser is produced. The produced laser has coherence, monochromatic and high directionality, so that it is used in many applications in communications as well as basic applications. I hope you understand the class. We will see in the next class. Thank you.